So how did you find out about our webinar today? Did someone send you an email? Did you get a tweet if you're on Twitter? Or if you're on LinkedIn, did you see the announcement? The way that we work with social platforms like Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn has changed the way we do business. In very elementary terms, Yammer is a social network, but for your company. It gives you new ways to ask questions, to work on projects, to collaborate. It also revolutionizes the way we do a lot of things. For example, that email that your group does about a new idea, instead of an email chain, you can use Yammer to really make those ideas come to life much quicker and much faster. We're going to show you that. There's a lot to show about Yammer. I can't do it all in 15 minutes, but we just want to kind of go through the basics of what Yammer is. It's available in many different flavors. There's a free flavor. There's one that if you work and get the new Office for Business for Enterprise, that comes with it. We can show you about how to get Yammer, but let's just kind of go in to what Yammer is and show you some of the pages. This is a typical page that you see for Yammer. It looks like those social platforms you know, like a LinkedIn, like a Facebook. You get your stories that you're following updated in the middle. You can post your own updates. On the left-hand side, there's groups. Groups is a huge thing about Yammer. We'll get to that in just a minute. On the right-hand side, you might see recent activities or suggested people to follow or suggested groups to follow. Following people, you know, just like you would on LinkedIn or Facebook, the things that you're interested in, you can follow and you'll get that information. This works for a company of 100 or 100,000. Yammer is part of Microsoft, and there's 100,000 people here, over 100,000. Not that they're all on Yammer, but they will be at some point, I'm sure. Let's dive into a couple things here. One thing that I wanted to talk about, though, was how social works with Yammer and how it works with the way that you now can work with it. Instead of that, it kind of blows up that organization structure that you sometimes have. It makes things a little more collaborative and open. And there are there's studies that show when companies bring in some sort of social, some sort of platform like a Yammer, it can increase productivity in workers 20 to 25%. Let's kind of show you how that works. You can see everyone in your company. If you have a company of 75, that's great. If you have a company of 100,000, probably not great. You can also just follow certain people. And as you like things, as you tag things, those people can become what's that top feed that you get with your Yammer. You can include stuff. You can put in documents, images, posts, polls, all of that in the environment of your company. And you can dive into that kind of stuff with Yammer. Yammer just works on a browser. I mean, it's a simple platform. It's not a program you load or anything like that. It's just a browser that's enclosed. If your company has a SharePoint site or SkyDrive Pro, you can kind of think of that closed intranet environment. You can share out to people outside of Yammer, but privacy, security, you know, it's just not all openness. I just want to kind of get that out. If you need to keep things private and, I was going to say secret, I guess there are secrets in the business world. You can certainly do that with Yammer. So groups is a huge part of Yammer. And the way that it works with groups is that you can set them up on the left-hand side here, and you can see this company might have one for the global sales or a product team, or it might be a project. It might be something, this Alpine Ski House merger, whatever that is. That may be a project that people are really interested in for a few months and then it will go away. You can include those folks in your groups. As you can see, this group here has seven folks in it. So I can post things to this group, files, information, and everyone can get to it and work on it. And then, again, if it's it's a group that other people can also look at. Groups are either public, which is they kind of this glass enclosed conference room where people can see what's going on. If they want to come in, they could. Now, in the real world, I don't think a lot of people do that. But again, if you're working on a project that you wouldn't mind if someone knew some information, or there's someone from that used to be in your group that maybe just follows you from time to time, they can just see that information and be able to share and bring in information that you're looking for. There may be someone who's looking for something and it's something they have an interest in, and maybe they're not in your group and they can share that information. That's that kind of open group. There's a line that I've seen from Yammer that I really like that works with working with groups is they want to encourage your audience to work out loud. I really like that saying, working out loud. Now, not everything needs to work out loud. I understand that. There's going to be stuff you want to keep secure. But again, a lot of the stuff you work on could use some outside influence, or some people might want to be interested in and could help you be more productive on that. At the same time, there is private groups, of course, in Yammer, like this closed conference room. By the way, this is like the coolest looking conference room I've seen. This is not at Microsoft, I know that. Maybe this is in the Yammer offices, but I wouldn't mind working at this place. But again, a walled conference room. So you just invite certain people. It's secure. Just those folks that are invited to that group will share that information. That's really important on that. But again, that kind of working out loud can work. And groups can be anything. It doesn't have to be business. You can do stuff like the old news groups. If you want to talk about more play ideas, work ideas, things for ideas for parents. If you want to talk about, I don't know, Super Bowl winners, you could do that too in your own group in Yammer if you wanted to. And then we can work on things like profile pages, just like you would find on with areas in LinkedIn and Facebook that you can put a profile so that people know what you're working on. SharePoint does this in some systems. But the nice thing is, and you know that long email you get about when someone joins your group? And you might reference that 6 months from now when you're actually working with them. You could post it here in Yammer, and then it's everything's connected. You see what they're following, what they're doing in Yammer. You can see their profile all in one screenshot. That's one of the things that works really, really well with Yammer. So here we go. Here is Yammer. We're looking at a fictitious thing called Four Leaf Consulting. But you can see I'm in the left-hand corner. I have some information here, the things that are going on in my company, this four leaf. I have recent activity. I have this news feed down here in the middle of just what's been going on. It just kind of rotates through the day. If you notice here on the right-hand side, I have suggested people. So this Phil, I could start following Phil if I wanted to, or Miguel. I have company resources here I can work with that are, you know, kind of good all up for dealing with Four Leaf, if I needed to know something about the overview deck or things like that, the kind of information. And of course, network policy. I have reminders up here in the upper left corner here. And I have these groups. So there's different groups here. Now, if I click on this Yammer TV group, you can see it says I have two more messages I have not seen. So it keeps track of what you have seen and what you haven't seen. Let me click over to Yammer TV. Christina has set some things here. So again, I can go into different areas. Let's see here. Let's go into the marketing area. So these are the conversations from the marketing groups, including myself. It looks like there's 122 members, a lot of members here. There's information. There's files. And they're stored here in Yammer. So here's all the files, which is great. So, and one other thing I wanted to show with Yammer is you can have different networks with Yammer. And if you look here in the bottom left-hand corner, I'm at Four Leaf Consulting. The one that says Microsoft, that's my Yammer for Microsoft. We're not going to go there today. But you can have different networks, but it all stays in this browser, so I don't have to re-log in or have different profiles. I can switch over to other groups that may be, some of these groups that we work with are with folks that work at Microsoft and outside of Microsoft, so it's more of a public Yammer space. So that area, I want to make sure if I am talking about things that need to be secure and private that I'm not talking about on that network. So you can have multiple networks in Yammer. So again, I can either, what other things I can do here? I can do a poll. I can add images. I can praise someone. So I can praise that and I can post that to my colleagues. Again, you can post to different people. You can just post to colleagues. You can post to everyone. You can post to groups. So that whole praise, that whole kudos thing is a big thing with business of making sure that people acknowledge certain people. It can all be done also inside Yammer. I want to get a little bit into email because I think that's important. There is an inbox for Yammer. As you can see here, we've done things. Here's a message that Christina and I talked about. There could be photos attached, inserts, PowerPoint presentations, all that within a conversation inside Yammer, and you can invite other people into it, much like you have a group conversation. If this becomes something bigger, I need to bring in other folks, I can do that right inside of Yammer with their email. You can do other things with email. Email is important because it kind of bridges the two worlds between what how business is working right now with Outlook, maybe, or some other email process, and then once they get on Yammer. In an email box, you can send announcements. You can talk about, you can do private messages. Again, not everything. Some people think social networks, everything is public. If you didn't know, in Twitter, you can send private messages to somebody. So same thing in Yammer. You can have that privacy. But you can add people to that conversation. Now, here's what I think the key part. I'm an Outlook person. I'm dealing with Christina, who's a Yammer person. The thing is, I get notified in email when somebody sends me something in Yammer. You can turn those notifications on or off. For now, I work more in Outlook than in Yammer. As you notice here, though, I could respond to this email into Yammer by clicking the link if I wanted to. Or someone could totally stay in Outlook and someone could totally stay in Yammer and communicate on those platforms, and they'd be able to communicate just fine because they work together on that. The notifications come through. So that's one of the great things as you start up and working with Yammer. Have no fear that I have my email and then I'll have to go to Yammer to get my other email. That's not the case. It can work backwards and forwards there. There's some tricks and other things like that that you can do. There's shortcuts. We'll show you those in just a second. But you can also cut off your email. So there's a lot of, they've done some nice bits of really thinking about how people communicate with email, with shortcuts, with other little tricks that kind of leave you, that work with the bridge between like an Outlook environment and a Yammer environment. And you can start group conversations in email. Let's say I set up a group in Yammer, and not everyone's bought into Yammer yet. They're still trying to figure things out. I can still email everyone within that group in Yammer just fine. It works out really well that way. And lastly, before we start on the, you can include people that aren't in Yammer. You can email them or work with them in Yammer, much like you can with any other area with other social networks. And the nice thing about is you can find mobile apps for any platform, I think. So for your phones, for Android, for iPhone, for Windows Phone 8, you can get apps so you can work with Yammer on the go and do a lot of that information. Or you can just, again, work on your browsers when you're on your computer with that. There's a lot more to talk about Yammer. We have a lot more information for you with that. You can find that information, including how to get it, pricing, things like that. If you go to aka.ms/yam123, we'll also have the recording of this webinar up there in a few days. Information about the Office webinar series in general, you can go to aka.ms/offweb. That's going to do it for today's webinar. Next week, we're going to talk about creating forms in Word back at Link in our regular platform. But for the folks at Yammer and the folks here today, thank you for joining this Office 15-minute webinar.